We're the rehab staff at Pain Physicians NY. We're physical therapists and chiropractors who believe in movement and how it can prevent pain, restore function, and lead to a better, more productive, and pain-free quality of life. In these videos, we will demonstrate to you progressive, easy-to-follow exercises that require little time, no equipment but your own body and a yoga mat, that will strengthen you, make you more mobile, will help prevent pain, and restore proper movement and function.
The exercises presented in this video were designed for patients with acute or chronic lower back pain. If any of these exercises will increase your symptoms, please stop them immediately and consult your physician.
The exercise programs are divided into beginner and advanced. So let's get started. Okay, Claudia, so this is gonna be exercise number one. I want you nice and relaxed, arms are spread out. You're gonna push your heels into the mat and slightly elevate your pelvis. And while you're doing that, you're taking nice deep breaths in, expanding your chest, taking in the full amount of air that you can, breathing right out. And we're repeating this 5 to 10 times. Okay, so perfect. This is one. Breathe out, bring everything down, nice and relaxed. Number two. Excellent, chest is rising and expanding. Perfect, number three. Excellent, relaxed, and four. And five. Okay, so Claudia, this is the second one. So this time you're nice and relaxed again. You're starting out with arms out front. This time you're gonna take a nice deep breath in and you're gonna try to eliminate the space between the mat and your lower back. So you're rotating your pelvis, perfect, and closing up the gap. And a good way to make sure that you're doing this correctly, you can take a hand and put it underneath the arch of your back and you can feel yourself pushing into it and squishing your hand to the floor. Again, you're repeating this 5 to 10 times. Very nice. Nice deep breath in, breathe out, push down with the lower back. And the last one, number five. Perfect. So this time, Claudia, this is exercise number three. You're gonna push down with the heels a little bit again. Your arms are nice and relaxed. Deep breaths in, and this time you're gonna elevate the lower back slightly and then push it right back down into the mat. Nice. As you breathe in, you elevate. As you breathe out, you push in. Number two, and again, we're doing 5 to 10 of these. Press down with the heels, elevate the back, and now bring it right back down. Excellent. Number four. Very nice, right back down, and five. Perfect. Claudia, so the position is the same now. Heels are pushing into the mat again, into the floor. Arms are nice and relaxed. This time you're gonna push in with one buttock, and there's gonna be a slight elevation of the opposite. So if you're pushing in with the left, the right one slightly rises, perfect, and then the opposite. You're pushing in with the right, and the left is elevating a little bit. Okay, left to right is one. Again, we're repeating 5 to 10 of these. So this is number two. Fantastic, very slight lateral motions of the hips. Number three. Very nice, pressing in with the heels, breathing in nice and deep. Number four. Very good. You're staying nice and relaxed. And the last one, number five. Excellent. Next exercise, arms are nice and relaxed again. This time, one leg is straight, 90 degrees at the ankle. The opposite leg is bent, so the foot is at the level of the straight knee. Okay, what you're gonna do, Claudia, is you're gonna elevate the leg slightly, keeping it nice and straight, only about 10 degrees. Hold it 1, 2, 3, and bring it right back down. Perfect, and again, you're doing 5 to 10 on each leg. So you're doing 5 to 10 consecutive on the left, and then repeat the same on the right. Perfect. You're bracing your core, so nice and tight at the abs and the lower back. Slight elevation. Right back down. Perfect. Okay, one more, and now the same thing on the right leg. Excellent, yep. So you want to keep this foot at the level. Perfect. This is 90 degrees at the ankle. Perfect. And now you're elevating again, about 10 degrees, right back down. Excellent. Number three, you're keeping that core nice and tight, the abs in the lower back. Nice deep breaths in. Excellent. Number three. Number four. Perfect. Nice deep breaths. And five. Excellent. Right back down. Next exercise, we're working on opening and closing up the hips. So the first one, Claudia, you're gonna keep the legs about shoulder width apart. And what you're going to do is you're going to internally rotate your hips a little bit wider, internally rotate your hips, perfect, and then come right back out, keeping the knees nice and straight. Okay, again, 5 to 10. You wanna make sure those legs are nice and wide, so when you bring the toes in, you have space. Perfect. That's three. Number four. Excellent. Come out, come out, come out. Good. And five. Okay, excellent. So the next exercise is we're working on opening and closing the hips up again. So knees are bent at 90 degrees. What you're gonna do is you're gonna open up your legs, let gravity pull the knees down. Perfect, just let gravity pull them down as far as you can. Arms out a little bit. Perfect, and bring them back up. Good, and out again. This is number two. Again, we're doing 5 to 10. And let gravity just pull you out nice and far, nice and relaxed, as far as you can go. Good, come back up. We're just gonna move the knees up a little bit. Okay, number three, here we go, out again. Let gravity pull, 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 nice and relaxed. Breathing in, nice and deep. Good, number four. Just try to be as relaxed as you can, so gravity just pulls those legs right out, opens up the hips. Perfect. Number four, and one more, number five. Nice deep breath in and out. Excellent. So this is going to be a nice stretch. So what you're going to do is one knee is bent, the opposite is going to come up. You're going to grab behind your thigh and pull it towards your body. Perfect, nice and relaxed, and you're holding this for 10 seconds, 4 to 5 times on each leg. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, beautiful, let it go, and then you're doing the same thing with the opposite. So grab behind the thigh, pull in towards you. Good, and again, you're holding for 10 seconds. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And again, you're doing 5 to 4 of these at home. Once more on the left. Grab and pull. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Great, and the same one more on the right. Go up a little bit higher, perfect, and pull towards yourself. Mm-hmm. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Great. Okay, Claudia, so this next exercise, what you're going to do is you're going to take one leg, you're going to hold behind your knee again, just as you had before. Excellent. And we're going to do some foot circles. So we're going what to the left. Perfect. One. We're going to do 10 to one side. Then we're doing 10 to the opposite. So 10 to the inside. Excellent. And then we're doing bending up and pointing toes out, plantar and dorsiflexion. And again, you're doing 10 in each direction. So here we're gonna do 5 to the left. Excellent. 2, 3, nice and relaxed. Make sure you breathe. Excellent. The same to the opposite side now. So toes are going towards the inside. Great. Again, you're doing 10 of these at home. Great, and now we're staying nice and relaxed, and we're coming up and down. Yep, beautiful, and then down. Up and down is one, we're doing 10 of them. Perfect, that's good. Mm-hmm. 9 and 10. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Okay, now we're going to do the exact same thing on the opposite side. So just as you had on the left, the right one comes up. You're holding behind the knee. Excellent. And you're doing 10 circles in. Perfect. Now 10 circles out. Excellent. And 10 up and down, plantar and dorsiflexion. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Okay, very good. Perfect. So the next one is the quadratus lumborum stretch. So we're starting with arms down, nice and relaxed. You're gonna take one leg. Yep. Sorry, it's me. You're gonna put it over the opposite, okay? So it's a 90 degree angle here, bent. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna rotate your hips. So the leg that's up is going to hit the bottom, hit the floor, just like that. Excellent. Then you're going to take the right arm. It's going to be at 90 degrees, and your head is going to come towards that arm that's splayed out. And you're going to feel a stretch right here in the right side. Okay, and you're holding it for 10 seconds. And then we're going to do the exact opposite to the other side. 7, 8, 9, 10. Perfect. Okay, come back to neutral. Excellent. So now we're doing the exact same thing to the opposite side. So the right leg is going to be bent. Excellent. You're rotating the hips to the right side now. So that arm, that foot touches the floor. Perfect. The left arm comes out and the head goes towards the left arm. The stretch is gonna, you're gonna feel is going to be right here. And again, you're holding it for 10. So 6, 7, 8, nice deep breaths in and out. 9 and 10. Excellent. Come back to neutral. Perfect. This is going to be a mid-back stretch, okay? What we're going to do is we're gonna take, legs are gonna be together in fetal position. So you're rotating to your left side first, hips are at 90 degrees, knees are at 90 degrees, and ankles are at 90 degrees. What we're going to do is you're going to rotate to the right side, nice deep breath in, and I want you to reach as far out back as you can and place your hand on the floor. Nice and straight, perfect. The head follows the hand, the arm. Okay, so in this position, nice deep breaths in and out, and you're just lying there nice and relaxed, holding the position for 45 seconds to a minute. Perfect. Try to relax. Have everything here in the mid torso open up. Excellent. So we're pretending that this is a minute, and we're going to do the exact same thing to the opposite side now. Okay, so we're going to come from neutral. Now you're going to go to the right side. Hips are at 90, knees are at 90, ankles are at 90. And now you're taking your left arm and rotating. Yep, you're holding the knees with the right. Very good. And you're coming out as far out as you can to open up the mid-back. Excellent. Nice deep breaths in. And again, stretch, stretch, stretch as far as you can out there. And you're holding this position for 45 seconds to a minute. Excellent. Okay. All right. So we're going to start with the pelvic tilt. So what you're going to do is these are the bones that are going to move. So basically your hip bones. So I want you to get into a pelvic tilt position. Perfect. And the way you're going to do this is by engaging your abs, your side abs, and your lower back. Okay. So once this is up, this is very tight. Okay. And we're going to hold this position for 5 to 10 seconds. Nice deep breaths in. The hips are up a little bit and the stomach is very engaged, as well as the sides, as well as the lower back. Nice deep breaths in and out. That was relaxed. And now we're coming into the pelvic tilt position once again. This becomes tight and there's a slight movement at the hip joints. And you can always see that once he's in a pelvic tilt position, this is engaged. So this becomes hard, and the lower back becomes hard. You're tightening the corset around. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna get into a pelvic tilt position, and we're gonna start making it a little more difficult by engaging the arms. So right arm is going to come up. While this is still engaged, this is engaged, this is nice and tight. Arm comes back and comes back down. Excellent. You're going to relax. Come into the pelvic tilt position again. Right, left arm back now. And you're doing 5 to 10 repetitions on each side. Excellent. Come back down. Great. Okay. Now we're going to do the pelvic tilt, and we're going to make it even more so, even more advanced. So pelvic tilt again. Now we're going to engage the lower extremity. So once you're in the pelvic tilt position, core is engaged, abs and lower back are engaged. You're elevating the leg, keeping the knee nice and straight, and the ankle is at 90 degrees. It's very important not to move your hips, just the engaged abs, and the pelvis stays in that neutral pelvic tilted position. Perfect. So you're going to elevate, hold for 5. Same thing with the left leg. This is engaged, core is engaged, ankle is at 90, straight leg, hold it for 5, right back down. And we're repeating this 5 to 10 times on the left and the right lower extremity. Excellent. Okay, if you see there's no movement of the hips, he's in pelvic tilt, this is neutral. The hips are not moving, slight elevation, very important to engage the abs and the lower back and not to let the hips move. Excellent. Okay, now we're gonna advance it once more. We're gonna go into a pelvic tilt position again, and now we're gonna elevate one leg and the opposite arm. So if it's left leg, it's right arm. Both are up, core is engaged, this is nice and tight, pelvis is in neutral position. Come right back down. Again, 5 to 10 repetitions on both sides. So now it's the right leg, left arm. This is a little more challenging. Have to keep that pelvis nice and tight by engaging the butt, the lower back, and the abs. hold and come right back. Okay, so next exercise is going to be active bridging. So we're not holding for a static hold, but it's going to be in constant motion. So legs are at 90 degrees at the knee, and they're about shoulder width apart. And what you're going to do is you're going to press down with the arms into the floor and elevate your tush, elevate your butt. Up, 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 up. Perfect. 1, 2, and come right back down. Good, and up again. Nice and high as far as you can go. Great, right back down. Okay, you're inhaling as you come up, exhaling as you come down, and we're doing 10 of these. Excellent. Good. 9, and one more. No big pause up top. 1, 2, and right back down. Excellent. This is going to be the active curl up, okay? So, knees are at 90 degrees, feet are on the floor, and what you're going to do is place your hands behind your head. Perfect. And what you're going to do is you're going to elevate, yep, just so the very top of your back clears the floor and right back down. That's one, and we're doing 10 of these. 2, excellent. Okay, relax your neck, relax your neck. No, nice and relaxed everywhere. You're just clearing the top part of your back, right back down. Perfect, number 9, and one more. Excellent. So this is the side tree position. It's a nice stretch. We're gonna hold for about 30 seconds, Claudia. Okay, so your left arm is underneath your head. You're facing to your left. Then we're gonna take the bottom leg. It's gonna be nice and straight. And the leg on top is going to be parallel to the straight leg with your foot planted on the ground. You're gonna open up the hips. Excellent. And you're gonna take the top arm and try to bring it over your head and get a nice, stretched position. Perfect. So keep this nice and open. So you want to stay on your side. You want to maintain midline. Okay, and we're going to hold this for about 30 seconds. Okay, just like that. Excellent. Try to reach out as far as you can up top. Excellent, without losing the position. So keeping this nice and open and maintaining sideline. Excellent. So we're doing lateral leg raises now, Claudia. So what we're going to do is your weight is going to be on that left elbow. The bottom, both legs are going to be straight here. Excellent. And what you're going to do is you're going to keep the top, both legs are straight and the right leg is coming up nice and high and right back down. Repeating this 10 times. Excellent. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. So this is the second part of the exercise where we're now engaging the bottom leg. So what we're gonna do is, these are straight once again. Okay, you're gonna elevate this leg. The top legs, both legs stay straight. Now the top leg is gonna remain in this position while you're pushing down with the bottom leg. And while you push down, you're gonna see a little bit of an adulation with the top leg. So it's going to move slightly. So push and push. Excellent. And again, we're doing 10 of these. 7, 8, 9. And you're really engaging those glutes on the opposite side. So your left glute. And 10. Excellent. Now we're going to do the exact same thing on the opposite side. Okay, so we're starting out with the regular leg lift. So nice and straight, leg comes up, just as before, and right back down. Excellent. Okay, we're doing these, we're doing 10 of these, so 7, 8, come right down, Claudia, right down, not too big of a pause, right down, and 10, excellent. And now the second part, bottom leg stays straight, you're elevating the top one, keeping it in this position, and you're pressing down with the bottom leg now, and really engaging those glutes. 2 and 3, and we're doing 10 of them. 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. This is a more advanced exercise now, so you're a little bit, you're in prone. Thumbs are up, arms are straight out, legs are straight back. You're gonna make a, you're gonna make a fist with your thumbs. Thumbs up. Okay, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna start with the right leg, arm, elevate it. 1, 2, bring it right back down. You're really gonna engage these paraspinal muscles. You're gonna feel them working while bracing your abdominals and your lower back muscles, and your glutes are nice and tight. We're doing 10 on the right and then going exact same thing on the left side. And left side, excellent. Nine and 10, excellent. Now we're gonna go on to the same thing. So you're maintaining the position, the stomach position, and now you're gonna elevate in the exact same way the legs. So we're gonna start with the right leg. You really have to concentrate on bracing your abdominals and your glutes. Excellent, 1, 2, come right back down, and we're doing 10 on the right, and then 10 on the left. A lot of work for your hamstrings, for your glutes, and for your lower back. Excellent, so this is number 8, 9, and 10, and the exact same thing on the left side. Engaging the butt, the hamstrings, and the lower back. Really concentrating in that stability, keeping everything in control. Number 9 and 10. Excellent. Okay, so the next set of exercises are going to be done in quadruped, which means on all fours. And we're gonna start with doing a stretch in this position just to get the body ready for the movements in quadruped. Okay, Claudia, so you're gonna go into a prayer's position. So you're gonna, really stretch out your butt and really kind of slide your fingers up forward to get a nice stretch. So you're sitting in and bending those legs as far down as you can and really stretching out with the arms out front. And again, we're holding this for about 20 to 30 seconds. Nice and relaxed. Excellent. Okay, come on up. We're gonna go into an abdominal bracing position in quadruped now. So very important that our shoulders are right above our wrists and our hips are right above our knees. So I want you to move this over a little bit, just like that. Just like that, excellent. So now what you're going to do is you're gonna engage the spine into neutral. So a way to find that is you're gonna go into extreme flexion and then extreme extension. Go all the way down, Claudia, excellent. And then you're gonna come back to neutral, like here, excellent. And you're gonna hold this. You really wanna engage these muscles to the point where if I'm going to push you, you're not gonna budge. You're gonna be one straight line, excellent. Nice and tight, nice and straight, excellent. So now for all the exercises we're doing in this next set, you want to remember this abdominal bracing position. That's your starting point. So from abdominal bracing, now we're gonna go into a cat camel stretch. So exactly. So what we're gonna do is you're gonna pretend there's almost a string here and somebody's pulling you up. So you're gonna go into extreme flexion and then right back down into extreme extension. Excellent. Good. Come back up again and we're doing 10. Up and down is 1. And back down. Excellent. We're not moving the elbows and we're not moving the knees. Everything is coming from the torso. Excellent. Right back down. Hold it 1, 2, 3. And we're doing 10 of these. Number 8. Right back down. Excellent. Number 9. Good. You want to keep that neck in neutral as well. Don't move the head. And the last one, 10. Up, up, up. Great. And right back down. Excellent. Okay. We're going into a neutral spine position again, okay? We're gonna brace the abdominals so this back is nice and straight, perfect. And again, if we need to find the position, we go into extreme flexion, extreme extension, and then bring it back up to neutral where it's nice and straight, perfect. So from this position, you're going to elevate the left arm or the right arm. Excellent. 1, 2, and bring it right back down. And again, making sure that this stays straight, no movement. Abs are braced, lower back is braced. So you're nice and stable. And we're doing 10 on one side with raising the right arm. Great. Number 8. Number 9. She's keeping good paraspinal, good back position here. And the last one, 10. Excellent. And we're doing the exact same thing with the opposite, with the left arm now. Excellent. She's maintaining the back straight here. The abdominal bracing is on. And we're doing 10 with the left arm. So 8, 9, and the last one, 10. Excellent. So now we're gonna do the abdominal bracing as always, and we're gonna do a leg drag this time. So let's brace the lower back and the thoracic. Excellent, neutral position. You're gonna take the right leg and you're not going to lift it off the ground. You're gonna extend it and drag it on the floor. Great, and drag it right back. So it's 90 degrees, excellent. And again, we're doing 10 drags on the right while maintaining a neutral braced spine. And then the same thing on the left. Excellent. 9 and 10. Great, now the exact same thing on the left. Keeping this nice and braced, this hasn't changed. Extend out, come on back in. Good, nice and steady here. Mm-hmm. And 10 on the left. Great. Number 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Okay, so now we're gonna make this a little bit harder, a little bit more advanced. So we're maintaining a braced neutral spine here. Okay, great. And now this time around, instead of dragging the leg, we're gonna kick the leg out and keep it straight. Kick out with the heel to engage the glutes and the lower back right away and the hammy, and come right back. Excellent, and we're doing 10 on the right. Heel kicks out, glutes are working, back is nice and straight. No movement here. If you were to put an object in the spine right here while he's doing this, it wouldn't move because he's maintaining a neutral braced spine. Excellent, number 8, 9, 9 and 10. Great. Now the same thing on the left side. So again, neutral spine. Kick out the heel, engage the left glutes and hamstrings. Come right back. Fall over. Excellent. Number 8. 9. And 10. Excellent. Okay, so now from the kneeling position, we're doing an iliopsoas stretch. So the front leg that's bent, I want at 90 degrees. So Claudia, bring the slide this back a little bit. You never want your, you want your, when you are stretching, the knee should not come up over the toes. Now the back leg, I want you to stretch it out as far back as you can. As far back as you can. Excellent. Good. Okay. And now you're going to sit into it, push forward a little bit, push. And then you're going to elevate that the arm of the leg that's being stretched. Excellent. And really pull back to feel the stretch right along here. Okay, excellent. We're going to hold it for 10. Very good. Good position. Keep it nice and steady. Excellent. Bring it right back down. And we're going to do the exact same thing on the opposite leg. So now the left leg is bent. Excellent. You're going to slide the right leg as far back as you can. Great. And really pull forward now. Push. And the right arm is going to come up and come as far back as you can to get a nice stretch along here. Excellent. Holding it for 10, 4, 5, 9, and 10. Excellent. Okay, Claudia, so now we're going in a sitting position and we're really going to engage the internal and external rotators of the hip. So legs are nice and straight, perfect. Ankles are at 90 degrees, and what you're going to do is you're going to point your toes in. Excellent. And then bring them out. Very good. And you're going to feel all the internal hip muscles moving and engaging. Go ahead, come back in. And again, we're doing 10 of these. Excellent. And back out. She has a lot of movement. She's able to bring both legs in and out nicely. Both internal and external rotators are working. Okay, Claudia, great. After this one, let's make it a little bit harder. So we're going to stretch out a little bit more. So exactly. So we're going to bring out the legs a little bit farther and we're doing the exact same movement. In, making sure that spine is nice and neutral, nice straight back, which she has, and out. Excellent. And back in. Great. And we're doing 10 of these again. So 8, 9, and 10. Very nice. The next exercise is going to be a quadratus lumborum piriformis stretch in sitting. So Claudia, I want you to keep the right leg straight and the left one is going to come over it. Okay, we're going to keep it at about, the foot goes right about where the knee is. You're going to hug the, you're going to hug the knee with the, so you're hugging the left knee with the right arm and really pulling it towards yourself to get a nice stretch here. And then you're rotating your torso to the opposite side, so to the left side. Excellent. And you should feel a nice pull all along here. Holding it for 10, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now we're going to do the same thing with the right leg. Excellent. excellent. So the left leg is straight now, the right knee, the right foot is at the left knee. You're pulling at the knee and rotating to the opposite side. Excellent, and we're holding it for 10 again. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Okay, Claudia, so now we're going to do another stretch. The next two are going to be in standing. So first we're going to do a rotation stretch. So if you can spread your feet about shoulder width apart, excellent. And let's go to the right side first. So you're going to place both hands on the hips, and you're going to rotate to the right side. Excellent. And then you're going to bring out the right arm. Palm is going to be out, and really stretch, stretch, stretch to the right side. Excellent. So everything is moving, but you don't want to move your feet. So you can go as far as you can without moving your feet. Excellent. Okay, and we're going to hold it for 10. So 8, 9, 10, and the same thing to the opposite side. So hands start at the hips. You're going to rotate to the left side. Palms facing out. Excellent. Going to the opposite direction. Get as much as you can without moving your feet. Excellent, we're holding for 10. So 8, 9, and 10. Excellent, and we're gonna do 5 to each side. Very good. Okay, Claudia, so we're doing one more exercise, one more stretch in standing. This is going to be a back extension now. So, legs are shoulder width apart. You're bringing your arms up and really bending back as far as you can. Excellent. And we're holding it for 10. Fingers are pointing out. Excellent. Holding this for 10. So 7, 8, 9, and 10, and relax. And we're doing 5 of these. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Okay, so Claudia, we're gonna start, these are the more advanced exercises, and first we're gonna do the snow angel stretch. So I want you to take your arms and bring them up as far over your head as you can. Excellent, and really feel your paraspinal stretching. Nice deep breaths in as you go up, and nice deep breaths out as you come back down. Pretend there's something on the opposite side of you that you really want to reach. Really extend your arms. Breathe in and out. Excellent, we're doing 10 of these. 7. Pull, 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 nice stretch. 8, stretch out, feel the paraspinals, the lats stretching, 9, and one more, 10, stretch, excellent, and come back down, very nice. The next stretch is going to be the knee to chest, okay? So we're going to do one leg, then the opposite, and then both legs together. Okay, so you're going to take the left leg, grab it behind your bed mid-thigh, and really pull it towards yourself. You're going to hold it for 10, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent. Come back out. Same thing with the right. Okay, remember to breathe. Pull, pull, pull. Feel the stretch in your glute and your hamstring. 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. And we would do 10 on each leg. And now we're going to do both legs together. Excellent. So you're going to hug behind the knees and really pull, pull, pull. So you feel the nice stretch in your lower back and in your glutes. Remember to breathe. And holding for 10, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. And we would do 10 on the left, 10 on the right, and then 10 with both legs together. So the next stretch is the tree pose, okay? So left leg stays straight, right leg is bent at the hip and the knee, where the right foot is at the left knee. Mm-hmm. Bring those arms all the way back. Stretch again. Feel like you're pulling for the pole up behind your head and right back down. Breathe out as you're coming down. Excellent. And we're gonna do 10 with the right leg bent. 8. Excellent. Pull, pull, pull. Come back down. Exhale on the way down. And now the same thing on the right. So right leg is bent, arms are coming up again. Stretch far, 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 and breathe out as you come back down. Excellent. And 10 on that side. 9. Excellent. And 10. Stretch, stretch, stretch. She's breathing in as she's coming up and breathing out on the way down. Excellent. Okay, so the next, now we're gonna make the tree pose a little bit more advanced. You're gonna take the leg and now instead of putting it next to the knee, you're gonna come over the knee. Excellent. Now the same thing, try to push that left knee into the ground or as close as possible without moving your pelvis. Excellent, and stretch and come back down while exhaling. Excellent. We're doing 10 of these on the left side. 9. Exhale on the way down and 10. Stretch out as far as you can behind you and back. Excellent. And now we're going to do 10 with the right leg. So left leg is straight, right foot, right ankle comes over the left knee. Excellent. And you're trying to push the bent right knee to the ground and come up with the arms. Inhale on the way up. Excellent. And exhale on the way down. And we're doing 10 of these. 9 and 10. Excellent. Okay, this is the last one of these. Very nice. So this is going to be the butterfly stretch. So Claudia, you're going to bend both hips and you're going to put your feet together in front of you. Excellent. Sole to sole. You're going to take your arms and place them on your knees and give a little bit of a pull. So this is a stretch, not an exercise. So you're really trying to elongate the internal hip adductor muscles. Okay, we're holding it for 10. Excellent. And relax. Mm-hmm. And one more. Feet are sole to sole, and we're applying a little bit of pressure on the outside, on the inside of the knees and pushing them out. Let gravity do as much as it can, and then you help it out a little bit. And holding for 10. 7, 8. 9 and 10. Excellent. So we're doing the hip crossover stretch. Okay, so Claudia, you're gonna put the right leg, yep, over the left, and you're going to pull with the left arm on the right knee so the right foot touches the ground. So you're gonna rotate the torso. Excellent. And then bring the opposite arm out to give it more of a stretch. You're going to feel it in the glute, in the lower back. And we're holding it for 10. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now to the opposite side. So left leg is coming over the right knee. You're rotating to the left. So the left foot reaches the ground. Excellent. You're giving a tug on that left knee, stretching out. Holding it for 10, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. And we're doing five to 10 of these on each side. One more to the left. Place that left foot on the ground. Excellent. Nice pull at the knee. Really stretch out with those fingertips. Up, up, up. Excellent. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Great. And then one more to the opposite side. Okay. Excellent. Pull at the knee. And then, Claudia, try just turning your hands so your palm down. Palm down. Excellent. And reach, reach, reach. Excellent. This foot is flat on the ground. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Very nice. Okay, so we're doing the iliotibial band stretch. So hands behind your head. Very nice. Okay, Claudia, you're gonna hook your left leg over the right. Just gonna swing it over, just like that. Perfect. And you're gonna pull with the left, yep, to get a stretch of the right. So the left leg is pulling down the right to get a nice iliotibial band stretch on the right. And holding it for 10, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And we're doing 5 to 10 of these to the right. So one more. Excellent. Bring it down as far as you can. Feel the stretch in here. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now the same thing to the opposite side. So left foot is on the ground now. Right swung over it. And you're pulling to the right side to stretch the left. Nice stretch along the iliotibial band right there. Holding it for 10, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And one more to stretch the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Very nice. So now we're gonna do some abdominal bracing exercises and we're gonna advance them as we go along. So first we're bracing the abdomen again. Okay, so tight up here, tight at the lower back, neutral pelvis, and you're going to take the right leg, straighten it out while maintaining this position. So you're going to breathe while maintaining nice firm abdomen, lower back. Hold it for 10, bring it back down. And we're gonna do 10 on one side. Brace, brace at the stomach, at the abdomen. Hold the leg up for 10, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And we're gonna repeat on the right 5 to 10 times. Okay, and then the same thing on the left side. So we brace, leg becomes elevated, nice and straight. You wanna keep it at about the level of the bent knee. Hold it for 10. Excellent. Relax. Brace the abdomen. Leg up. Hold it for 10, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. The next exercise, a little bit more advanced for the bracing. So we're bracing the abdomen. Both legs are coming up, 90 at the hips, 90 at the knees, 90 at the ankles. And we're gonna do an alternating kick while maintaining the braced position of the abdomen. So that's nice and tight. And we're doing like a bicycle lying on your back. Extend out, come on back, while maintaining that position of braced abdomen. We're breathing out as you kick out, breathing in as you bring it in. Breathe out as you kick out. Excellent. And we're doing 10 of these. Left, right kick is one, we're doing 10. So 9 and 10. Excellent. So the next step to this progression is called the dead bug exercise. So we're gonna brace the abdomen, elevate the legs again, 90 at the hips, 90 at the knees, 90 at the ankles. And the starting position for the arms is straight up into the ceiling. Excellent. So while we extend the left, we're gonna push back with the right arm and come back to neutral. And the same with the opposite. Left arm, right leg extension. Excellent. All while maintaining the braced abdomen. You're gonna breathe in as you kick out. Breathe out as you come back to neutral. And again, we're doing 10 of these. These are a little more advanced. Make sure that abdominal position is held. If you cannot hold it, start with 5 instead of 10. And 9. And 10. Excellent. So this is the next progression. We're gonna brace the abdomen again. Legs are going to be elevated, same starting position as previous, knees at 90, ankles at 90, hips at 90. Now you're going to spread out the arms and legs are gonna rotate from the left side to neutral to the right. So you want to maintain the 90-90 position without having the legs touch the ground while rotating the pelvis. Excellent. And we're doing 10 of these once again. Left, right is 1. 9. And 10. Make sure to keep that abdominal stability nice and strong. The next exercise is going to be the abdominal curls. Feet are on the ground, about shoulder width apart, knees are bent, arms are behind the head. You're not pulling on your neck, they're just there for placement. And you're elevating the lower back. You're elevating the back to clear your back bones, to clear the scapula off the floor, and come on back. Make sure you breathe in and out as you come down. We're doing 10 of these. Excellent. Number 9. Breathe out. And 10. Breathe out. Excellent. So the next exercise, we're gonna go a little more advanced from the curl-ups. Now we're going to add a twist. So once again, feet are shoulder width apart, hands are behind the head for placement. And now as you come up, you're going to rotate to one side, come back down, rotate to the opposite. Left-right rotation is 1, we're doing 10 of them. Make sure you breathe, and you just need to come up high enough to clear the back bones. Excellent. 8, 9, and 1 more, 10. Excellent. So the next exercise is called static bridging. So feet are shoulder width apart. Arms are down at your sides. You're going to elevate your butt. And while you do that, you are bracing at the abdomen, and you're gonna feel a lot of squeeze, a lot of tension in the glutes. You're holding them nice and tight, as well as in the legs. We're holding for 5 to 10 seconds. If you cannot do 10, you're starting with 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and exhale as you come back down. Legs become relaxed, glutes become relaxed. And up again. Really squeezing the butt. Squeezing the legs, bracing the abdomen, Concentrate on that breathing and exhale on the way down. Excellent. Okay, and one more. Number 10. Up, bracing the abdomen, squeezing the glutes, holding for 5 to 10, and come back down. Excellent. The next progression to the bridging is bridging with heel raises. So the same starting position, arms are down, feet are shoulder width apart, bracing at the abdomen, holding the glutes, holding the legs, and now you're going to elevate the heels, left, then right, and we're doing 10 of these. Left, right is one. If this is too difficult, you can start with 5 and bringing it back down. Up again, brace the abdomen, hold the glutes, start lifting the heels. Left, right is one. We're doing 10 of them. Okay. Further progression, the next bridging exercise, we're going to add some steps to the bridge. Okay, so shoulder width apart at the feet, elevate while bracing, squeeze the butt, squeeze the legs, and we start doing stepping. Left, right is one. We're doing 10 of them. If this is too difficult, you start with 5. Excellent, right back down. Once again, brace at the abdomen, hold the glutes, keep the position, make sure you breathe. 9 and 10, excellent. So now we're going to do the bridge on one leg in the progression. So arms are down, feet starting position is shoulder width apart again, and we're gonna start with elevating on the left leg. So left leg is straight and bracing at the abdomen, squeezing the glutes and coming up, and you're holding it from 5 to 10 seconds. Once again, very important to engage the glute that's holding you up. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and relax. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, excellent. Okay, and we're going 10 on one side and then 10 on the opposite. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, excellent. Make sure you squeeze those glutes so the pelvis stays in neutral and doesn't fall out of place. One more on the left, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Excellent. So we're doing the next exercises in sideline. So first we're going to start with the stretch. We want the knees, the ankles, and the hips at 90 degrees. Legs are together, propping yourself up on that left shoulder. What we're going to do is you're going to take the right arm, palm facing down, and stretch out as far as you can to the side, keeping that shoulder at 90 degrees. Make sure you breathe in and out, and we're holding this position for 45 seconds to 60 seconds. Make sure you concentrate on the breathing, stay nice and relaxed. Excellent, and then we're going to do the exact same thing to the opposite side. Great, so the feet, ankles, knees, hips are at 90 once again, propping yourself up on the right elbow now and stretching over to the left. Palm is coming down, face down. Excellent. Getting a nice rotation of the torso. And again, we're holding this for 45 to 60 seconds. Nice and relaxed. Make sure you concentrate on your breathing. Try to really extend those fingers to get the most stretch and rotation that you can. Excellent. Okay, so this is in sideline position. Once again, we are gonna go from a sideline position into a side plank. So you're bearing weight on the bottom leg and that left elbow. Right arm and fingers are used for stabilization. You wanna keep the spine neutral. Come up and down. And we're doing 5 to 10 of these. Make sure you breathe. Breathe out on the way down, breathe in on the way up. Excellent. 5 to 10 on the left side, and then we're doing 5 to 10 on the opposite side. Now the weight is on that right elbow. You have Again, we're doing 5 to 10 of these, depending on how advanced you are. Excellent. And 10. So now we're going to do the regular side plank. So left elbow is going to be at 90 degrees, feet are together. Right arm is sideline at the top leg, and we're lifting off the pelvis while abdominal bracing. And again, we're holding it for 5 to 10 seconds. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Make sure we breathe on the way down, and we're doing 5 to 10 of these. One more. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent, and now the same thing to the opposite side. 90 degrees at the right elbow, feet together. Left hand is sideline, and we're holding 5 to 10 seconds. 7, 8, 9, and 10. And we're doing 5 to 10 of these. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. So we're gonna go on to a progression of a great exercise for the gluteus medius, which is one of the primary stabilizers. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with the clamp. So Claudia is gonna have her knees together, feet together here. And what she's going to do is she's going to open up the legs as far as she can and bring it down. And that is called the clamp, which is one of the primary exercises targeting that gluteus medius. We're going to do 30 of these. Up and down. Excellent, nice controlled stable motion. Excellent. 25, 26, 27, excellent, 28, 29, and 30. Okay, great. Now we're going to do the same, only a little bit more advanced. So this is the advanced clamp. So what we're going to do now is Claudia's gonna take that leg and just elevate it slightly off the left leg that's on the ground. And she's going to do the exact same motion without the stability of the bottom leg now. So we're gonna open, close back up, that's starting position, open up, and back down. And again, if 30 of these is too much, we can start with 15, making sure that when that leg comes down, starting position is in the air, but parallel to the opposite leg. Excellent. Three more. two, and three. Excellent. Okay. Now that was the clamp. Now we're going to do the reverse clamp. So the starting position is the same. Knees are bent, feet are together, except this time instead of lifting the knee, we're going to lift the leg. So this is called the reverse clamp. As far as you can, and right back down. Once again, challenging the gluteus medius, one of the primary gluteal stabilizers. Excellent. Again, 30 is optimal. If we cannot do 30, let's start with 15. So we're going to do four more. Excellent. Two. Three. And four. Excellent. Now we have the advanced reverse clamp. So the starting position is the same. You're going to elevate a little bit, finger width apart from the opposite leg, keeping it parallel. And now Claudia is going to do the exact same motion of the reverse clamp, only without the stability of the bottom leg now. Excellent. And again, if we can achieve 30, fantastic. If not, we'll start at 15. Continuous motion and three more. That leg parallel to the opposite. And one more. Excellent. So the next set of exercises are going to be done lying on your stomach. So these are going to be, we're going to lie on your stomach and you're going to elevate, these are called Supermans. So this is the beginning of the Superman. So we're going to elevate the left arm and the right leg out at the same time. Make sure that abdomen is braced. You're holding for 5 to 10 seconds. 3, 4, 5, bring it back down. And now the opposite, thumb is up, arm comes up, leg comes up. 3, 4, and 5. Left, if we start counting from the arms, left arm, right arm is one, and we're doing 5 to 10 of these. 4 and 5. Now, right arm, left leg. 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep the pelvis neutral. Excellent. And one more. Left arm, right leg. 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now, right arm, left leg. One more. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Excellent. So the next progression to the Supermans is going to be the half Superman. So Claudia is going to take arms are a little bit further out, outside the head. Thumbs are up. Thumbs are up, excellent. And she's elevating her head and her top of her torso, holding it for 5 to 10 seconds. 3, 4, 5, and we're doing 10 of these. So 8, really squeezing the muscles between the shoulder blades and your paraspinals. And 5, excellent. Relax, and one more, okay. Excellent, good position. Thumbs are up, really squeezing the muscles behind the shoulder blades. And relax. Again, we're doing 5 to 10 of these. Okay, now we're going to advance to the full Superman. So it's the same arm position as previous. Arms are up, and now legs are up as well. Lend the arms out a little bit further to reach the rhomboids. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and back down. And we're doing 5 to 10 of these. Number 9, 2, 3, 4, 5. Excellent, and one more. Again, we're holding for 5 to 10 seconds and we're doing 5 to 10 repetitions. 4 and 5. Excellent. Excellent. Now we're going to move to the next step. This is the most advanced of these. So now hands are alongside the body for starting position. Okay. And you're elevating the top of the torso once again and holding it for 5 to 10 seconds. 2, 3, 4, and 5 and relax. And we're doing 5 to 10 of these. One more, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You wanna make sure those thumbs are nice and high. Okay. Okay. 2, 3, 4, and 5, excellent. So now we're going to do 2 stretches in prone and face down position. The first one is called the Sphinx. So Claudia is going to get propped up on her elbows. Excellent. Hands are about shoulder width apart. And she's getting a nice stretch here. And push out right with your elbows, maintaining your elbows on the ground. And you're holding this for 10 to 15 seconds. 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Now relax. And again, we're doing about 5 to 10 of these. We're going on to the advanced Sphinx stretch with arms extended. So Claudia is going to prop up on her elbows and then hands are shoulder width apart. And then she's going to extend her arms and extend her elbows. Get a nice stretch. Excellent. We're holding for 5 to 10 seconds. And we're repeating this 5 to 10 times. Excellent. Relax. And then one more. Extend out. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Excellent. So we're doing the cat camel stretch in quadruped, so on all fours now. So Claudia is on extended arms, arms are straight, knees are bent at 90 degrees and they're underneath her hips. She's going to fully extend her back, really pull up, 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 as if there's a string attached and somebody's pulling, and drop it down. Get a full flexion of the lower back. Excellent. And we're holding each position for 5 seconds. And we're repeating it 10 times. Up and down is 1, 8, 4, 5, and drop down. 2, 3, 4, and 5, and one more, up again. Stretch, stretch, stretch. 3, 4, and 5, excellent, and drop it back. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Excellent. Okay, we're moving on to the quadruped cross crawl. So Claudia is going to be on all fours. We want the knees lined up underneath the hips. Excellent. Hands are going to be shoulder width apart. You want a neutral pelvis, so you're gonna brace at the abdomen as we've done before. And now we're going to elevate the left arm and the right leg and extend out while maintaining the braced abdomen position. We're holding for 5 to 10, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now we're doing the opposite, left arm, right leg. While maintaining the neutral spine, braced position. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Excellent. And we're doing 5 to 10 of these. Once again, left arm, right leg, while keeping the braced abdomen. three, four, five. Extend those fingers forward. Excellent. And now the opposite side. Left arm, right leg. Excellent. Stretch out front. Maintain neutral. Don't let the pelvis fall. Two, three, four, and five. Excellent. Okay, Claudia, we're gonna do the iliopsoas stretch now. So I want you to take a nice large step forward and kneel on your left knee. Excellent. Now you want a nice big stance. So when you flex forward and really extend the ligaments here, your knee should not come over your toes because it's very bad for your ACL. Okay, so both hands on the right knee, really come forward a little bit more, neutral spine, and you feel the stretch right here. Again, we're gonna hold this for 10 seconds. 7, 8, 9, and 10. And do the same thing to the opposite side. So nice big step with the left leg now. Excellent, get into position. Right knee down. You want your leg out a little bit further to get a bigger stretch. Scoot forward a little bit more for me. Excellent, and lean forward. Excellent. And now she's feeling the stretch right here in the groin. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. We're repeating 5 to 10 of these on both legs. Nice big step, left arm down. Just place your hands like so we can see the knee. Excellent, and you feel the stretch in the left groin. 7, 8, 9, and 10, and one more on the right side. Nice big step with the left. Excellent, right knee comes down. Both hands on the left knee, and push forward to get a nice stretch in the right groin. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Okay, Claudia, so now we're gonna do some of the more advanced exercises. We're gonna start with the forward lunge. So hands are on your hips, very nice. You're gonna take a giant step forward. And you wanna squat down, excellent. So the left knee is practically on the ground, but the right kneecap is not coming off your toes, so that's very good form. Come on back, and we're trying to do 10 of these in a row. Squat down into it, excellent. 7, 8, nice. 9, good, and one more. Excellent. Okay, so now we're gonna do the reverse lunge, another progression. So Claudia, you're gonna take the step backwards now. Excellent, plant the right foot and just make sure that like that left kneecap does not come over your toes. Excellent, come forward, stand up. And again. Excellent, good form, squat down into it. Come on back, and again, we're doing 10 of these. So 8, good, 9, excellent, and one more. She's keeping the back straight, hands are on her hips, knees staying nice and straight at 90, is not crossing over the toes, fantastic. Okay, so now this is the last progression of our exercises. This is going to be the side squat. Okay, so Claudia, starting with her hands on her hips, she's gonna take a step forward, squat down, meet up with the other foot, and now to the right, step down, squat meet up with the other foot. And we're doing 10 of these. So that's 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent.